What do you see?
Let's see. Looks like just an expanse.
Just an expanse. How do you feel in this place? Use all of your senses. How does this place feel?
Like I am that.
Very good. Very good. So let's close that scene. Close that scene, leaving that person to be on its own now. And I'd like for you to connect with your higher self, with your Oversoul. Do I have permission to connect with Michael's Oversoul today?
Yes.
Thank you very much. I know you could have shown Michael many different lifetimes today. Why did you show him what you did? What was that all about?
I just see it.
What is it? What is it he's supposed to see?
Nothing.
Why did you show him nothing?
So he doesn't wander too much after.
Okay. You want to keep him focused on something?
No, not necessarily.
Tell me why you showed him that, why you gave him that experience.
Too much I wanted to see. You'll see everything, but you'll project it.
So you'll show him things that he'll need to see?
Yes.
Would you tell Michael what was the reason for incarnating in the year that he was born? As the person he is right now? What's his mission and purpose?
Fluid.
Fluid, to be fluid?
Yes.
But you gave him a very solid body. Can you explain what fluid means in the spiritual sense?
Perception. What he's seeing is what he's seeing. And it's here. Don't necessarily destroy it, let it allow it, let it be its fluid.
Anything? You've given him quite a bit of exploration recently. What's he trying to learn from all of this?
Willing to jump back in.
Willing to jump back in?
Experience.
What was he before? He asked about his last two lives and he wanted to know about them. But you didn't choose, you chose not to show it to him. What were his last two lives?
Right.
light. Mm-hmm. What else? Did he ever have a human body?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Doesn't need to see too much more.
Okay. Can you explain to him why he doesn't need to see it? Because a lot of people come to me here to see past lives. Why does he not need to see it?
Because it would act as another tether. There's other places beyond what he's already seen here.
Mm-hmm. Where are these places?
Inside.
Mm-hmm. Have you taken him to these places?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So should he be dwelling in these places within?
No.
Mm. Can you tell him about that?
All the worlds are still your projection.
Mm-hmm.
You stay there as long as you wish. Don't lose. He's there. He's gotten caught before.
Mm-hmm.
By himself, is the thing of being. You can get so far into it to where you would lose who really who's really there as you.
Mm. So he has gotten himself in such spiritual practices that he's not being a human?
It's both.
Both.
He's gone human. But the limitation of human,
mm-hmm.
by wanting to see something that's really not there.
Okay.
It doesn't mean that you're human because you have eyes, ears,
mm-hmm.
legs.
What does it mean to be human?
Thought.
Thought. Mm-hmm. And he had seen his thought there projected. Uh-huh. What was that thought about? Was it just a random thought that he was looking at?
No.
What was the thought?
The thought of coming down.
Hmm. To earth? Good. To earth, you mean?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Earth.
Tell me about that. You seem to find that funny.
Earth is the it truly is. It's the heart.
True. Earth is very hard.
It's the heart.
Oh, the heart.
We all share it.
Ah, okay.
It's one heart.
It's one heart.
One mind.
So why does there seem to be so much separation if we're all one heart and one mind?
Remember, I told you today it's perceive it.
Mm-hmm.
Once you perceive it, it becomes because you perceived it, you brought it into being.
Mm-hmm. So whatever.
No good being. No. What I mean by You don't bring things and then just leave them. It's you.
So once we create something, it becomes real?
Forever.
Forever. So whether you think that you're looking at it or not, it's still created.
Yeah.
It's still real.
Yes, it becomes something that you can visit.
Ah, for what purpose?
Because you called it into being.
Okay. So it's, really, all of life is our creation.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. What would you say to people that create such terrible circumstances and they want to change?
What has happened is you've fallen back into your the primordial self. And you build worlds. You build them from a standpoint of looking like you're outside of it. But you can choose to go into it or you can leave it. Most parents want to be with their children, so they go into it, and the children becomes a parent, the parent becomes a child. And then you learn. You go into, the people that end up doing such, they're learning. Some choose not to come out of that state.
Okay. So let's say people who have been in very violent situations, did they create this?
Yes.
For what purpose?
There's a side of power that each part of yourself that you create has to stand before its opposite.
The shadow part of it?
It's not necessarily a shadow. It just is. It's just power.
Okay.
And when you go into other perceptions, you tend to forget. Because in order to perceive your creation, you have to become your creation.
Okay.
And all of your thought can't go into what you created, if you want to believe that you actually created it, because
well, people don't want to take responsibility for what they've created.
Yeah, their children. The thoughts that you are creating are your children.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're birthing them.
Yes.
So how can you get a handle of all these crazy children running around that you've created?
You call them back home.
Okay.
You call your thoughts back to you. And after you're done, you're going to know that there was no more, that you could have done less or more. But you bring them back inside of you. And find you find yourself there, and you love yourself, and you make it new.
Okay. So you can kind of re-educate your thoughts as if they were children?
Yes.
Redirect them?
You have to.
Okay. Is that what Michael is doing now?
Yes.
With his meditation and practices?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What should he be paying more close attention to spiritually?
Breath.
The breath. Mm-hmm. Is there a particular way that he should be doing the breath? He tells me he practices it quite a bit. Is he doing it correctly?
No.
No?
No.
Can you do a demonstration for him as to what he should be doing with the breath?
Yeah.
How will he know when he's doing the breath correctly? If you, his Oversoul, won't teach him.
Because when he breathes, when he starts to see that, he doesn't feel like he has to breathe. But he has to breathe more with his whole body. And be conscious of breath all the time. Then he won't be conscious of breath anymore.
Okay. Is this breath that we have to do a deep breath or just conscious of it?
Just the conscious of it.
Okay. Why should we be paying attention to the breath? I thought it was something automatic that we just do.
It's your first representation to the in and out. It's an inward breath and outward breath. Before that, you play and you dance and you sing and you do everything that you do in this world. Just as you create another world or thought, physical, you have to breathe into it for it to have life there.
Okay.
And then you breathe back in and you stop it for yourself. Because it's still going to go. Never stops. We like to play with the thought of it stopping, but it just doesn't. Michael sees that. He doesn't.
Once you create it, it's there.
It's there.
Okay, good.
Yeah, it's there. Very turn.
Why is it that he got this Bell's palsy? Would you tell him about that? What were you trying to tell him with that?
Sometimes he thinks his way through too much.
What does that mean?
When he knows what to do, he thinks about it. I don't want that.
You want it to just flow?
It has to.
So he uses his conscious mind too much, his logical mind too much, weighing it and such?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
To what?
The, Michael knew he had a situation that he fought with for too long. It was energy.
Okay.
And he was lying to himself.
Okay.
He was saying, oh, it doesn't bother you. It doesn't bother you.
Mm-hmm.
But it bothered him.
Mm-hmm.
And that was a blow of an energy. It was, that energy had to come out.
Huh.
And that's the, I don't like to use it, but that's the better way that it had to manifest itself.
It could have been worse.
A lot worse.
Mm-hmm. Can that be healed now?
No.
Why is that? I know that the Oversoul can change anything in a body. Why? Why would you not correct that now?
Because it speaks to Michael on all levels.
Hmm.
Needs it to be able to see.
Okay, so it's a reminder to him?
Yes.
Okay. Good. Would you tell him a little bit about the sun and how he's to use it? I know he was doing some sun gazing for a while. And he wants to know about the thoughts and frequency and being able to unlock its dominion.
The sun, as it, stands now, is a stuff that's okay. The sun is the high, the head.
Mm-hmm. And what does that mean?
It means that he has to be able to go beyond the head, meaning his thoughts have to go beyond even the frequency of thought, if that makes sense. But still being conscious of that thought, if that makes any sense. So what the sun represents is literally him and all of creation that he's brought into being, that you've brought into being, all oneness. As a reminder and a representation above you, just as you have one that's below you, it's the earth that you stand on. So, in order for him to not transcend the sun, but it's to bring the sun to the earth. In the earth to the sun, it's a role reversal, it's a switch. People look up and they say, oh, I want to go there. They look up to places to where none of their other creations can survive there. It's only you.
Okay.
If you want to be alone, you've never made it so. And this is what I'm trying to tell Michael. Look around you. Keep them where they are, their eternal states. But they're their own state too. It's
a little bit more complicated.
It's way more. Mike's trying to wrap. Mike's trying to wrap his mind around something that will defeat. This is why the bill is passed. Each, if we want to call them persons, each one is given their bandwidth or their as much as they can hold.
Okay.
There's different places, and if he doesn't see that, they can't. You can't hold too much.
Mm.
Not here. This is why I'm trying to get him to release that mind. He has to relax. Because what he's looking for, if I allow it, he'll fry himself.
Mm-hmm.
And he won't.
Too much.
Yeah.
He won't function.
No, not here. He'll function.
Mm-hmm.
He'll function, but he has... Yes, he has a family. He has people that are looking at him, and he'll be here, but he won't be here.
Mm.
It's what you call crazy in this dimension. He'll be crazy.
Well, some people say that they're looking, they're so hungry for knowledge. And I kind of envision it as them trying to put their mouth up to a water hydrant and drink too much. It's like they can't. It's too much for them. Are you saying that it's the same thing with Michael? If he tries to take too much in, he'll just fry the circuits.
Let me be clear. There's never a thing of too much.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm trying to get Michael to see is that, just as anything else, that there's ways of being more conductive.
Mm-hmm.
And until you do that, don't go into get too much. You have to have room for what you're about to receive.
Okay.
And he needs to learn to make the room without making the room. See, it's a paradox. It gets... Michael wants... a lot, and he's got it, but it just has to be, since where you are, there's the world wouldn't hold it. You've already created this with you have other brothers and sisters that are you, but they're individualized. Don't take that away, and if you do it too fast, you'll take that away.
Mm.
You'll lose yourself and everyone else in the process.
Wow.
And this has happened before.
Mm. In what way?
Almost how a computer is. You can, you know, use it, put it in safe mode, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And you allow a program to run.
Mm-hmm.
Even though something's created, or you think something, it still is eternal, but there's, now that you've done it, you can step from it and let it run. And then go back into it and show its perfection, because there's more of you.
Mm.
There's more of you. And I'm trying to tell him that. And it's...
Oh, he wants another upgrade. He says he's ready for it.
Yeah.
What can he be doing to get an upgrade?
Yeah.
Is he ready for an upgrade?
Yeah. Yeah, the upgrade. I don't like the term.
What would you like to say it as? Those were his words.
Yeah. Relax. See. The control. Is I gotta be careful. I don't know how to put this, so I know he needs to understand. Okay, the control that happens on Earth.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
There's a certain amount of power that's here, that's allotted for this dimension.
Mm-hmm.
And what I mean by dimension is there's a collective that every part of yourself shares, and it's an agreement of what's going on here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the thing about Earth is Earth isn't just what you think that you're standing on. It's beyond that. But collectively, we needed somewhere to express and made the projection of what we deem as Earth.
Mm-hmm.
Truly, see, Michael. Michael has to slow down a little bit. You know, he's got a lot of he's got to relax.
Mm-hmm.
There's what you want to call time. There's time. But we're giving him everything that he needs for this period and those that are connected to him. Because see, what Michael fails to understand is everyone acts as a generator, as this is the thing, is that most aren't conscious that they're giving, sending, receiving, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what Michael has to realize is that there's others that if he takes his frequency too high without balancing that out with everyone else in the reality, there'll be no reality.
Hmm.
Not necessarily just for them. For him.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to lose your projections because you've wanted the whole pie. The whole pie belongs to you.
Mm-hmm.
But how rude of you to eat it all when there's others, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I'm trying to get him to see. It's like, Mike, there's others.
Mm-hmm.
Let them play. Let them eat a little bit, you know? Yeah.
So this upgrade would not benefit him?
Michael's got an, I don't like the term.
Mm-hmm.
Upgrade means that there, you know, there's something more. There's nothing else. There's nothing more.
Okay.
What? Learn the mechanics of where you are and be happy being. Be happy being.
Okay. Good.
So, when that's done, now you've put yourself into a position to where whatever projection that you make in, you bring that, but you got to bring everyone with you. And if Michael continues on this, what he wants to do, he doesn't see the end to it, mm-hmm. because he's still in this program. Okay. And that's all I'm trying to tell
okay.
him. That's
okay.
all.
He has been doing a mantra, a wholeness and balance vibrations.
Mm-hmm.
Would you explain that to him?
Oh, definitely. Yeah. I said it. There's only one mind. This is the wholeness. This mm-hmm. is the whole. Now, for one to try to encapsulate that in what we're looking at in human bodies or any other body, the wholeness can't be looked at, because how are you going to see it?
Mm-hmm.
So all that is trying to do is trying to remind Michael, there's nowhere to go. There's no salvation. There's nothing that you need other than just to remember. Just remember, it's whole. Don't take a piece of it. But you have to take a piece of it. See, it's paradoxical. That's the beauty of it. Because if not, you might learn that. You'd have another tyrant. You'd have another god. You'd have another guru. You'll have another. It's whole.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So don't try to eat the whole thing. You'll be sick. Right?
Mm-hmm.
The balance. Once you understand the concept of the whole, if you don't understand, you take it out of balance and you'll destroy all of your creations.
Mm-hmm.
We've ran that simulation. Oh man, we've ran that so many times.
Mm-hmm.
That's another reason why we made Earth.
Hmm. Why was Earth made this way?
Think about a child, right?
Mm-hmm.
You have a child. The child will do whatever it wants to do, right?
Right.
It'll eat. It'll fall. It'll do it because it's unhindered. Mm-hmm. So it can destroy itself and everything else around it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there's no way I can put this because of who you are. Earth was made slower. It was made so that you could have every feeling and beyond. And what I mean by that is that Earth itself, people say that Earth cries, that Earth is angry or mad or sad. No. No, it doesn't have feelings like that. We made it so that we could have the feeling, so that we could be the blade of grass, so that we could be everything here. And I'm telling Michael, and he asks all the time, like, where? It's everything, but yet it's nothing. Everything but nothing.
Would it be correct to say that each person's projection of what Earth is and what we're supposed to be doing here is their own projection?
It's more than yes, you're yes, yes. That's why, again, so there can't be only one God. There can't be only one. The fact that I'm speaking, and Michael's going to look and say, oh, is that me? Did you see? The fact that you're interfacing with me, am I really interfacing? What? So no, there can't be just one's own perception of what they think Earth is. That's what you guys call a lie. It's a lie. But then guess what? It's still not. Because if they believe it, they'll be in there until they're done with it. And that's why we're here. Because you're able to explore any and everything. But you've done it already and you just don't remember.
Is this why reincarnation? Why we come back?
That process has to do with more than just you know what people you know term as reincarnation. It's a frequency, okay? So the thing about the frequencies is that they're always merging or wanting to merge or marrying, or some just maintain a frequency, like my projection of Earth, right? If it doesn't maintain this frequency, if people think that you're coming in and out of bodies, you'll never know that I'm the one talking to me right now. So where am I reincarnating to? I'm having an experience of myself. So you know, it's a fanciful term. I mean, and there's other parts of yourself that you can connect with. This is a thing of the ancestors, okay? Like when we throw around this term, the ancestor, ancestor.
Yes.
The ancestors are inside of you, and are you? It's just, which one are you willing to listen to? Which one are you going to magnify? Because we do it every day. You know, I'm here.
Where do you, as the Oversoul of Michael, reside? Everyone wants to know where their Oversoul is. Is it inside? Is it out there? Where is it? Is it part of our soul? Is it our soul? Is it our mind?
All I want to do is laugh.
Inquiring minds want to know.
Guess what? That'll be something that you'll want to know forever. There is no place of residing. That's another what you would call a lie.
Okay.
The reason why I won't answer the question is because when I do, I place the limit. See, the soul is something that we don't even really speak too much of, mm-hmm. because you place a limit, which is, it's still, see, that's the thing about when you want to connect. Remember, I just told you about that pie. Yes. If you want to become the whole pie, then you're nothing anymore. See? Mm-hmm. Now you can start to eat from it. And some people can eat a lot of the pie, right? Mm-hmm. So it's like that for who you are. You're going to eat as much as you're able to eat, but there's more. So don't ever think that you're going to pin down to where you've come from, who you are. What you can do that for the planes that you're into. You know, if I'm on Earth, yeah, I can connect to things on Earth. Okay, let's talk about it. But the soul? Yeah, that's enough of that. That's enough of that.
Why is it that Michael came through the Jehovian fields, and why has this frequency encapsulated so many?
Primordial children. What Mike fails to realize is that he gave it a name. He called it Jehovah, right? Or Yahuwah, or whatever. Mike has come to know many different names for this.
Okay.
Right? Mm-hmm. It's a frequency. And the frequency that all perceive gods outside of yourself, and I don't like to use the term, that frequency is fear. Mm-hmm. It's fear from being who you are. Mm-hmm. So whether he chooses to call it a Jehovian field, a Luciferic field, once you stop with the names, the mm-hmm. titles, and that, mm-hmm. you see, especially if I'm going to deal with Michael on Earth and the projections, see, look, it's like this. If you read books, if you read anything, if you do anything, you've already done it. That's why you're looking at it. That's why you're reading the book. The book, you can say, well, Jack Frost isn't real. Well, if Jack Frost is in your mind, Jack Frost is real. So, why the Jehovah's field? Because you were born in America, Mike. That's why. You don't have to have a... You see, that's him. Mm-hmm. Wanting a title, there's a battle there. He says that he got done with battles, and it's natural. It's natural.
So this is a frequency, like a religion is a frequency.
Most definitely.
Okay.
One of the strongest.
So when you are a person that comes to this earth, and as a child, you reject a religion, like I did. It's that you're rejecting that frequency. You don't resonate with that frequency?
Yeah, you see the pattern. Mm-hmm. Because it does. It lends itself almost to it. Not almost. It lends itself to a shape. Right? And once that shape becomes like a flash to you, right? Especially as a child.
Yes.
And it hurts. So you're not necessarily you're not rejecting a religion. That was something, but you're rejecting something, and I don't like the term. you've done it enough. You've done it enough. And that's you've set this I want to answer the question. Religions are necessary to keep a bundle of power from exploding before it should. And that's all we're dealing with, is we're dealing with power. We're all powerhouses. I mean, this is it's one power. That's what you need to know. Just Mike says it. He says, hey, there's one, you know, wholeness. It's one power. The religion helps you because you chose to do it again. Helps you to see another side of it. Just look at it like that. And yeah, so.
Okay, good. Good. He says that when he was in the field, he heard a woman's voice that said, don't lose your seed. Would you explain that for him? What was that seed? Was this a physical thing? Was it a spiritual thing?
It's both.
Both.
The body that he chose to incarnate in is a male body. That's governed by certain energies. And the way that that energy is moved up through the body is through the male seminal fluid.
Okay.
Now the seed that Mike was in the field, totally different. But I had to speak as a woman because Mike was, he was feeling orgasmic. It was, but I told him, don't lose your seed. The reason why I had to do that is because Mike was, he had an experience. His vibration was going so high, he could have corked. He could have gotten out of here. That. What I mean by out of here, it's, he wouldn't have been here anymore. He would have been what you call, like I say, crazy. He would have been, you would call him a blundering fool.
Okay.
So, at that time, that's why I had to speak with him like that, because he would have gone too far in orgasmic. If you want to hold a body here and hold it in, you know, where you can have sessions like these and ask the questions that you already know the answers to, you know, I speak this. Michael knows exactly. Now, physically, yeah, he should retain his seminal fluid. Mm-hmm. And like I stated earlier, is learning the mechanics of that. Mm-hmm. And knowing what a sexual union is, it's not just a pleasure. It's not just for pleasure. It can bring that. I mean, beyond, see, if we're going to deal with physical, there's things, you see it in your reality, you plug a plug into the wall, you know, you call things male and female, mm-hmm. everything on this dimension, everything in on earth is that way. Okay. There's a going in and a coming out and a birthing. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, if you have too much of coming in or going out, that which you birth will be distorted. Okay. Mm-hmm. So in the body, if there's too much fluid, too much energy, because that's what we're dealing with. See, mm-hmm. Mike takes it and says, oh my goodness, but we're dealing with the energy. You have to know how to move that energy within yourself. You have to know how to move that energy within the environment, within the elements, within, see, it's oneness. And the better that you play with yourself, you've heard the term, oh, go play with yourself. Truly, go play with yourself. But I'm not talking sexual, but if you have to do that, nay. Mike needs to retain his seed, mm-hmm. but there's plenty of ancestors here. I told him what ancestors are. It's just another part of yourself. And the balance of doing that is, again, Mike knows the difference. It's part of the journey for him to search it and find out. Mm-hmm. I don't want to take that from him.
Now, is that something that everyone should be doing or just Mike?
I can't speak to that.
Okay.
But, you know,
I mean, so what you're basically saying is you would prefer that he not ejaculate.
Yes.
But how about others? I mean, is that...
Okay. I would have to bring it and speak to it on the way that you're asking it. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. For Michael, no. For others, there is a plumb line, meaning there is certain things that should be done and certain things that shouldn't be done if you want a specific outcome when you're dealing with the pole and the hole or the mm-hmm. zero and the one. Mm-hmm. Okay, so should everyone be ejaculating? No, because it creates a short circuit in the body and in the mind. And what it doesn't allow for is that connection of the conductivity that's needed for them to hook back up with their oversoul or me. Hmm. So now the thing about it is that you can make a conscious choice, a conscious decision to stay outside of that. Or you can follow what the blueprint is or the map. We all have them. Mm-hmm. We all have others that are speaking out in full recognition of who and what they are, right? Mm-hmm. But if you choose not to do such, then the only one that's going to really, if you want to call it suffering, is going to be you. Mm-hmm. So, direct answer, should everyone practice it? Yes. Will everyone practice it? Yes. Because, see, if you want to stay connected to the physical, then you do the things of the physical, meaning... Mm-hmm. you can reproduce and you can have a child and you can have another body. But what you're filling that body with, because we're talking energy, mm-hmm. is going to be the less conductive part of yourself. So you, when it talks about, they say, you want to upgrade. Mike asked about an upgrade. Mm-hmm. Here's how I can put that for him. Learn to control your what you bring into dimensions, meaning other minds. Mm-hmm. Then there's your upgrade. So what I'm saying is you can have a child, and if you don't know what it means to cultivate the seed, and the cultivating the seed really goes into how much of your or the soul you're willing to encapsulate, and again, not controlling, but being fluid with that force. Okay. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I think that's enough on that, because it can get,
it can go on forever.
Almost definitely. but on only because of being here, not,
yes,
you know?
Mm-hmm. Well, he wants answers today.
I don't know if he necessarily, we'll give him what he needs for today.
Okay.
He'll be okay.
He'd like to talk about his relationships. And he wants to know if he should move forward in his current relationship.
Mike keeps asking that.
Is he afraid to make his own decision?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We'll see. So, what I was like, and then I was like, okay, well, why not? Why not? And I,
so that's
I can't give him words. It's not good for Mike to have a yes or no on this one. it just, because what it will do for him will create another, he has to know that it's coming from him.
Okay. He has to make his own decision.
Yes, because okay. I he can look at me as a god.
Yes.
Can't do it.
Okay.
So I can't
make really, your own decisions.
Yeah, I can't give him an answer okay. to that question.
What about his children? How can he reach his children better?
Michael has to realize that his children have come here. We tend to think that it's, I just kind of explained it a little bit, but I'll go back through it. We're unpacking ourselves, okay? Mm-hmm. If I can... What I mean by that is, I said this earlier too, there's only one power in the world, okay? Mm-hmm. And that would be you. And that would be each part of myself that I've birthed, if I can say that. So my children, it's me, but they're still them. Mm-hmm. Understand what I'm saying? What I'm saying is that some people say, oh, well, you know, they chose to be here, true and not true. So what Michael needs to realize about his children is that they're extensions of his consciousness, but individualized for their own. Because again, we're unpacking ourselves. So he needs to be able to see them as himself. Mm. No different. But himself as remembering what it's like to have phenomenal power but not knowing how to use it. Mm. So Mike's immediate children, mm-hmm. what does he need to do?
Yes.
He needs to speak. And the speaking, see, speaking creates a tone, it creates a vibration, it creates a sound, it creates a color, it creates an action. Mm-hmm. I said all those for a reason. All of those create. So he needs to be the speaker, creator, and seeing them in the end of, I don't like the term, but the end of where he would like them to be, and keep them there. Don't deviate from that. But when you're speaking, that means you're doing, you're producing the color, you're doing the vibrate. It's, you have to do it. You have to do it.
When you have a child, would it be best to project what it is that you see them as? Hold them in that vibration?
No.
What would be best?
I just said that the child is an extension of you. You've already given birth to it.
Okay.
So now it's a thought, or it's a development that has to develop itself.
Okay.
So the projection, or what we again, there's only one power, and it's you. So what you're doing is that you're just here to allow, to facilitate that. But remember, the only thing that you don't, if I use these terms, yeah, I kind of understand where I'm coming from, because this is hard. The only thing that you don't want to do is allow them to destroy themselves and someone else. What I mean by that is, each time you image yourself, each time you flash yourself, you create another you. And I said, how well do you play? Mm-hmm. You gotta, so the child is another frame of thought of how you're thinking, and it has its place to work. So your projection really of what you think that individual, that child is, it becomes just that. It's your projection. Mm-hmm. So you gotta, it's paradoxical. You gotta be careful, but you can't think that it's a game, because you're not a game. You don't play with yourself like that. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. He has a question about the death process. I mean, he wants to know how he could stay awake. Is it like the DMT process?
Yes.
It is.
Yes. It is, and I can't. Yes, it is. But it's not. Okay, so what Mike needs to know is this. DMT is totally different than, he's heard it said, been said that, hey, you know, it's the, you know, it's the death process, the same thing that's being released, it's not true. What happens at I got to be careful, because there's some that have used and gone through a DMT experience that they thought that they were going to die. Mm. But there's a difference between knowing that, see, you still have an awareness that you used a substance or you used something to put you there. But when you're faced with the total onslaught, or knowing that this, what you've played in for how many years, is coming to an end, there's a difference between that. Mm-hmm. And so what happens is that there's going to want to be a merger. And that merger is the merging back with me. And not to the point to where, hopefully this is where the tuning comes in, of where I said you're here. Hopefully you've gone through the trials with yourself of knowing you're gonna, when you, what they call die naturally, mm-hmm. or through an accident, or everything at once will converge upon you, okay? Mm-hmm. And you'll see them as lights, mm-hmm. as want, desires, and that's base pillar, okay? And then it blows from there, and you see yourself cosmically. And as the frequency starts to go so high, you start to shudder, right? Mm-hmm. Okay? And so now you'll look at yourself, and then you'll start to choose. You know, but you're not choosing in full awareness that you're choosing. You're choosing in fear.
Okay.
So what happens then is that, and I kind of want to be careful, because see, you can't use a cookie cutter with any of this, because each person's death process, mm-hmm. is similar to what I'm describing, but it's different. But I'm trying to give a good overview of, you know, okay. for lack of better words. So the DMT, it only gives you, it gives you a segue into that, to where you look and you're astonished by what goes on there. But if you go deep enough, you get to that point to where you feel like you've maybe, you might not be returning, mm-hmm. you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But the death process, can you stay awake and stay conscious through it? Train now.
Okay.
Well, and what I mean by that is that, you know, it's been said that you can, you know, train with the DMT, you can train without it. No, you have to do them both, meaning Michael has to do them both, not you or anybody mm-hmm. else. Mm-hmm. Michael has to do them both. So will he stay awake? Yeah.
Okay. Good.
Yeah, he has nothing to worry about.
Is there still a fear that he hasn't dealt with?
Yeah.
He's ready to face it now.
You said he's ready to face it now?
Yeah, he says it. He is? Is he? Or is he just saying it?
He's ready. I've been saying it since I've been here. Mm. How come, what part of relax don't you understand? I mean, that's, you know, that's where, that's really where it all, how well can you relax? Mm. See, when you relax, it means that you don't send out something that says, I can be gotten. Mm. Or that there's something else. That's Mike's fear. But see, I think he thinks that he won't be okay if he thought that, but he's all right. He needs to know that. He needs to know that. It's just, Mike, stop fearing. The fear of yourself, let it unfold. Unfold, Mike. Just, yeah. Good. Yeah. Yeah. But as far as in the reality and things like that, does he? No. No, there's nothing else out there.
Good. Good. How does he activate the dormant frequencies in his DNA in balance? What abilities does he have that are dormant?
Better question. Mm-hmm. See what I mean? See, that's Mike.
He has to identify it first.
Right. He wants to, you know, put some DNA on it. Okay.
On the pie.
Right. Good. Yeah. What Mike has to trust is that there's a story that he's designed, and that it's like the fool, right? Mm-hmm. So with the pack on his back, mm-hmm. and he's got all this stuff packed in there, and you know he's getting ready to walk off the ledge, but inside there, if you had opened up the bag, you would have known that there's no ledge. Mm-hmm. Meaning, what Mike needs to do as far as activating he's saying his DNA, his body. You told him a little earlier, you said, listen, you know, listen to your body. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. That's good advice. That's good advice. But guess what? It's a body. Until you show it, see, it's all. You remember I said flash. You have to flash something, right? Mm-hmm. The body is made up of cells, and when you show another cell perflection, it you flash it. It emulates it, right? Mm-hmm. Now, other cells in the body are not wanting to do that, right? Mm-hmm. So there's a movie called Flash Dance. Almost like that. Who's going to flash better? So listen, so what Mike needs to do is just, all he needs to do is this. Become one with the body. Be careful, because the body has been doing this for a long, 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 long time. So it's connected to what we call this collective consciousness. Okay? Mm-hmm. Meaning, if I take some fire and I put it on my hand here, I'll say, ouch. Mm-hmm. No. It's not me that's burning, it's the flesh. Mm-hmm. Again.
Yeah. It's his connection.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So in order to, for him to really understand that, is that all he has to do is say, okay, well, let's go the opposite of that. What's the opposite of that? The opposite is this. If you want to activate the DNA, what does this DNA, what does this body run off? It runs off of light, sound, frequency, vibration. Mm-hmm. So that goes back to that mantra that he's learned. Wholeness and balanced vibration, right? So once that becomes more than just a mantra, but your food, mm-hmm. you have no choice, but the body has no choice but to respond.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So he's activated. He's you know what Mike's doing? Mike's waiting to do something again. I don't like the question.
Does he have any abilities that he can use to assist him in this reality? For example, I would say psychic or anything like that. Does he have anything like that? Any superpowers like that?
Another one of Mike's questions. I love him. Does he have any abilities?
Mm-hmm.
I gotta be careful with this with him. This is amazing. Yeah, he has abilities. He does.
How can he use them? And does he know about them already?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, at some point, I don't think he Mike has to unlock those abilities in his dream scope. In his dream scope. They're see, I'm kind of looking through that question right now.
Mm-hmm.
And he's sending an overtone like, does he have any abilities?
Mm-hmm.
No, you're not walking on water, buddy. No, see, I'm going to just leave it. I'm going to leave that. Yes, Mike, you have abilities. Because of the way your mind thinks, I can't give you that. You have abilities. You've seen some of them. You've seen them in action. So just play easy with yourself. Don't. It's okay.
Here's one that, of course, is Mike's too. What is this collective plane for me, and how do I use it in balance for me and others?
This is a place where you act it out, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, once you, this is a very serious question. Because what it involves other parts of yourself and how careful you are to nurture yourself,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So, like I said before, every time that you give rise to a thought, you give rise to a reality. Anytime that you read a book, they've even told you in this reality, they said, well, you know, every time you read a book, you go to another place. The fact that you read that book, you're in that place.
Mm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
The fact that someone else reads it and they believe it, you're in that place. So now this goes on ad infinitum, right? If there wasn't a place that contained all that and can keep it, this place, they called it a garden or an enclosure in the Christian
mm-hmm.
tradition, right? But to be real frank about that, it's the body being on this dimension.
Okay.
So this collective frequency, this collective place where we are on Earth, it has to contain those frequencies, because if so, you would spiral out too far in other parts of your, if we want to, because we are all out just imagination.
Mm-hmm.
But if I believe that I'm Spider-Man and Spider-Man is where I'm supposed to be. Are you understanding what I'm saying? What I'm saying
mm-hmm.
is
mm-hmm.
if there is no governor for that, that's why we have a moon. That's why we have an earth. That's why you have a body.
Mm-hmm.
Then you will become what you call gods, a god of a certain thing, of a certain place, a certain chakra, a certain point in your body. You'll get stuck there. So that's what this reality is about. This reality is very much about learning the mechanics of what it means to be free and unhindered and untethered, but then taking the responsibility for that, because you can create, and we always already do. You read, you know, the Bible, you read George Lucas, Star Wars. There's so many realities that's been cast. Mm-hmm. If you don't contain them, you'll never find your way back to yourself. That's why.
Okay. Good.
But those, you see, it's paradoxical. Because those still are you. Mm-hmm. But it's let's say the child part of you, because you still want it. Now you are in the Marvel Universe, you need or the Star Wars, you see what I mean? You need the opposite. You need, I got to fight.
The bad guy.
You do.
Yes.
You know, and so until you can merge all of those where you see that all of this is me.
Yeah.
And then then you don't destroy what you've created. Mm-hmm. See? That's why it was created.
Okay. Well, something happened to him very strange. One day he saw a person change form into what it seemed to be a reptilian. Mm-hmm. What was that? Mm-hmm. He seemed to have been in a state of mind where he was seeing things as they really were. All the subliminal messages on TV were actually being shown to him. And then he saw this person, and it turned into a reptilian. What was he experiencing?
It was experiencing what's called a schmear.
Schmear?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That sounds interesting.
Yeah, well.
What is it's, a schmear?
Yeah, it's a concept, right? Mm-hmm. When you look upon the body, right, you see a face, right? Mm-hmm. But that which powers the body, you can't see. That which makes up those skin cells that you think mm-hmm. that you see,
yes.
You don't see. Right?
Mm-hmm.
If you had the eyes of a microscope, mm-hmm. or even of a different life form that's here, even present on the planet now, right?
Mm-hmm.
You would see something totally different. So those powers that Mike was asking about,
yes,
it's part of what was happening there.
Oh.
Is that if you could truly see what you've created to go, that's behind what you're seeing. It's just like, you know, some will call it that they're channeling me, that I'm separate from Mike or whatever. But no, what I'm saying is if you could see what's directly behind, case in point, that's what happens with the death process, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Okay. And the DMT. You start to see, and even the DMT at first, until you start to become, it's like anything else, practice makes perfect, right?
Mm-hmm.
But until you, once you start to see what's behind immediately of, you know, the skin, you start to open up into what, a little bit of what the elements are.
Mm-hmm.
And those primordial base hard holding frequencies that most people will call themselves adepts or most people would say that, oh man, I can do it, I've been doing this, I think I can say if I could.
Mm-hmm.
If you're still holding one of these, what I mean by one of these is this body.
Yes.
You haven't done it. you haven't. We want to try to master something.
Yes.
That's not for this plane. Meaning, Yeah, you can bring the fancy of it here, and you can see the mechanics of it. Don't get me wrong, you really can. You can see the mechanics of it, but in order to do that, you can't operate inside of it, if you understand what I'm saying.
Okay.
You can't be the president and still act like you're the worker at GM. You see what I'm saying? You can't do that.
Good. What is it that he saw flying over him in the sky in Michigan? Why is it that he saw it? What was it and why? It was a triangular looking thing.
It's the same question. It's the same question. It's a smear. It's again, if you peel the skin back, see, those 12, there's systems here. And the people think that the greater that you get out into systems, meaning, people say, oh, I want a fourth dimension, eighth dimension, and
Yes.
24th dimension. No, you're going the wrong way, sillies. Meaning the body has 12 systems, right? But you peel each one back and you get to see what happens there, but there's still something. There's what you would call a God that resides over that. Okay?
Yes.
And until you go there and you're able to deal with that part of yourself that governs that, you stay in the body to which you're able to handle that frequency of. Remember, I said earlier, everything is about conduction here, meaning if you're not ready for it, I have a purpose for that, Mike. So you're trying to see too much, but you saw it because I needed you to see it. Now I'm giving you, and I've given you the explanation through this.
Good.
Just don't put too much on it. Don't take too much away from it.
All right.
Yeah, that's what he needs to
Were
know
these
now.
gray orbs supposed to be telling him anything?
No.
No.
No,
It was just an
don't.
experience.
Part of that is what people fail to realize is that anything external, again, remember, you've created it.
Okay.
So let's look at it as for what is Mike in now? Like, what are you in now, Mike? Oh, I think you're in a body in this collective frequency, right? So what these orbs represent, they're nodes, okay? And other people are the connections to those. So all I'm trying to show you is that there's connections that are being made. That's all. Just make the connections. Know what it means to connect. And Mike needs to take heed to remembering that certain people in this reality don't pump too much power and too much juice into them. Meaning, he has to learn how, again, it's other people are still you, so you have to play easy with yourself. You don't give a child gasoline, but don't go judging and thinking that, because some children can take the gasoline. So Mike knows, tell him, Mike,
Has Mike and you as the Oversoul merged consciously?
Yeah.
So when he speaks, he's speaking as his Oversoul.
No.
So, no.
No. No.
He's thinking.
Do you think, let me ask you a question. Do you really think that who would be able to talk with you if you were speaking? And I am Mike. Mm-hmm. I'm using Mike's personality, but I go beyond this. Mm-hmm. But because of where Mike is, this is what we do.
Okay.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, Mike's merged, but you know, I understand his question, because there's some that, again, this is about, remember I said that those orbs, those things are nodes, those, mm-hmm. you know, in the body can be, the wires can get crossed, and mm-hmm. that signal of making that merger, making the that which is above, so below, the right, the left,
right.
the up, the down, the fat, the skinny, this, until you merge all those, you'll go from place to place to place, and it creates what you call a burnout,
mm-hmm.
a short circuit,
because
you're still looking for something that's already been there.
Hmm.
You're looking for yourself. Stop.
Okay.
Yeah, he's merged.
Good, good. Would you do a body scan on him and see how his body is doing today? What do you find?
It's got that he's got a cycle.
A cycle?
He's got a cycle more of his energy from his crown, his return circuit.
Mm-hmm.
He tends to get it caught
. Can you do some adjustment on him today, please? Correct that. What else do you see? How's his
health? He's picked up a bad habit again.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. He's just that.
Can you help him with that?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. So let's rewire him a little bit so he doesn't continue with that habit.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah.
Okay. Anything else? He's asking about his diet. Is it okay? His supplements, are they working?
Hmm.
processing.
Yeah, supplements could.
Mm-hmm. What about his diet?
Diet needs more help.
Okay, what would you like to suggest for him?
He's been at the Candida.
Mm-hmm.
Causes short circuits.
Okay.
He's got to know that.
Mm-hmm.
And not he's got to know it. He knows it.
Would you work with him on that?
Yeah.
Give him some guidance?
Yeah.
Okay. What about his chakras? Are they aligned? Are they okay today? You had said something about his crown.
Yeah, no. No.
Okay. Not. Would you align them for him, please?
He needs to know something.
Mm-hmm. Tell him.
Both. Yeah. Sun and Earth, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mike is, even his question about the abilities, I see through it.
Mm-hmm.
You want to stay too high up in the crown, and you can't do that. You can. I mean, you can do. I want to be careful. You can. He can do it. But there's no one there. He's gotta. He's getting caught on his back circuit. He's pulling the energy up. But he's getting caught at his throat.
Mm-hmm.
Keep cycling that energy down and ground it back to the earth. The earth on two levels,
mm-hmm,
is the heart. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the physical earth. There's a lot of power here. You are powerful. So be, almost send this to him as a warning.
Mm-hmm.
It's got to be careful. It's got to be careful.
Keep his feet on the ground?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's not to take away from what he's saying, but he knows.
Okay, good. What about his aura? Do we have, is it intact? Is it good?
Because of what I just stated, he leaks from the top and from the bottom. If you want to give a juxtaposition to it, those are one of the worst places to leak from.
Mm-hmm.
And again, how that's rectified, it's real easy. I'm gonna walk him through it.
Okay.
Right now, I mean,
good.
He's fine. He's going
good. Because of his leaks, has he attracted any influences that shouldn't be here with him? Or does he keep his vibration high enough to keep them out?
Yeah.
He does.
The Candida. It's a vibration, but for the most part, no, Mike.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't, but definitely the Candida.
Mm-hmm.
It, what I don't really think that Mike understands is that each one of these, there are things that he's created, mm-hmm. came together.
Mm-hmm. Why did he create that? Why would people create that?
Because it's... It's like anything else. You create it. And because it comes from you,
mm-hmm.
it has a thought of being aware. Everything is self-aware.
Of course.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So... In doing that, everything on this dimension has to eat.
Mm-hmm.
And really, this goes cosmic, okay? So, again, there's a place for candida. There's a place for everything. I mean, everything is contained in you,
mm-hmm.
okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's just the weight, the shape, and the measure of how you're going to distribute your alchemical cabinet or your very own body. So mm-hmm. Michael, he's playing too much with a frequency that is very strong, very dominant on this dimension.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why is because it has to hold a frequency that most people can't look into because they can't see it in balance, but it's necessary. So don't throw good or evil on it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like the best thing I can give you so you can understand this would be, you know, like dirt or flour or rose, all of that. It's, you don't see it when it's ugly.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because you haven't yet wrapped your head around how to do it. So if Mike wants to play with Candida, he better fully understand what it can really do. And in doing that, if you know what frequencies to thwart it, have at it. But if you don't, have fun with that. And that's all I have to tell him about that, because he knows this, and you know, it's fine. And, you know.
Does he need to keep it?
I'm sorry, I don't
know. Does he need to keep this candida?
What? I said it earlier. Yeah. Everything is you're unpacking.
You're unpacking.
So does he need to keep it? Of course.
Mm, okay.
But when you unpack, you just don't throw things out onto the floor. Well, I mean, yeah, you do. People do. But you put things in their places,
yeah.
right?
Uh-huh.
So that's everything that Mike has to do is there's a place for every part of himself. It's inside, yes,
yeah.
okay. But if we're dealing with this reality, then it has to be seen in such a way of you know how to build this world. You know we've done it.
Mm-hmm.
Now put them back in their places.
Good, okay.
Yeah, it's fine.
What message should he be delivering to the universe, to all of his sisters and brothers out there?
Mm-hmm. All that we think that we embody, we're more than. And what I mean by more than that is, to be very direct and very frank, the message is to release the fear. Release people from the fear. Show them what it means to be orgasmic with themselves. And for those that don't know how to handle that, I don't mean physically per se. Mm-hmm. What people are really thriving for is something to take the place of themselves. Because again, yourself can be very expansive if you're not in remembrance of, again, you're unpacking it. So you don't pull out the hammer before the screw. You don't, you see what I'm saying? What I'm saying is that people are starving. They're looking for what the greatest question is okay, well, what am I? I told you earlier, you're everything. So should you try to understand what everything is on this, in this body? Yes. Now, can you in this body? No. How much can you? Depends on you. So if you show someone, you call it love, but don't like the word, because love, you know, to you, it just means, oh, I love you and everything is great. That's not what love means, but we'll deal with it in the way that you know it. Love will allow you to grow. Love will allow you to reach those that can't be reached. So you think. Now we're going to talk about the difference of what that love is, okay? Love is telling someone a truth. Mm-hmm. Not the truth, a truth, okay? Mm-hmm. I gave you the example earlier. A truth is, if I take my hand and place it into some fire on this dimension, mm-hmm. you will be burned. So getting away from all the fanciful, you know, namaste, whatever you want, getting away from that. How can people take what you're bringing them, Mike? What is the message? Can it be brought to a way to where they can hear it? And what they're wanting to hear is, show me who I am and the tools to do that. And, you know, Mike's got a great mentor here. You know, so, you know, it's
just listen.
Yeah, well, yeah, he's linked up with excellent parts of themselves in this reality. Mm-hmm. That, man, I mean, yeah. Cool. The message is plain and simple. Be the message. That's okay. It. Be the message.
All right. Is that what everybody should be?
Everybody should mm-hmm. be. But you guess what? Depending on what story you're getting, what story you're reading yes. or wanting, that's the message you're going to get. Okay. You see, you remember you asked earlier,
yeah.
you asked about, you know, what is earth and what is, okay, but yes. What story are you telling yourself, silly? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How much of it, what do you want?
Yes.
At every point, in every turn, to the degree that you've made yourself ready, you can change it. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wonderful. Is there anything else that you would like to tell Mike today in closing? Or anybody else?
Yeah. There's too much of not accepting the responsibility of being, I just said it, there's too much of not accepting the responsibility of being, okay? Mm-hmm. We're trying to let you know that you're on a path that you've chosen for yourself. And whether you think that it would be me or another being to let something else do that for you or say what it is, this is why even some of the answers I said I couldn't give Mike. Mm. Because you don't, that's lying to yourself. You don't want to do that. So what I'm trying to tell humanity is stop letting an archetype or something that you've created in the mechanics of it, meaning if you want to ride a bike, you build the bike, then you ride the bike, right? You don't become the bike and think, oh man, I want to ride a bike.
Uh-huh.
And that's what we've done. We've built a world. We came in and we lived in the world, right?
Mm-hmm.
We've built a body. Let's keep it to where Mike can understand it. He's built a body for him.
Mm-hmm.
If you experience the body, you're contacting me. And then if you don't make that merger, if you don't make that link, you still think that you're the body.
Mm-hmm.
And body identified is almost where you stay, and it create for not almost, you will stay there until you're done. There's no, you're not going anywhere. You see what I mean? There's nowhere to go. And this is another thing, is that what I mean by that is you're going to go where you've projected yourself. Meaning if you are sitting saying that you're a Buddhist, you're going to go to the place where the Buddhists go.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? You will finally realize that this is another world. It's another created reality. But there's more. Throw that hand in and keep going.
Okay.
That's all. That's it.
Thank you very much. Are we complete today?
No. Just wanted to tell Mike to relax.
Okay.
Relax.
Thank you. Are we complete now? Okay. Thank you so much for all the help you've given Mike today and for everybody else. Welcome back. How do you feel?
I feel good.
Feel good? What do you remember? Your Oversoul?
Yeah. It was
pretty tough, huh?
Real,
you know?
Yeah.
Pretty
yeah,
tough. Real dominant. You got spanked quite a bit.
Yeah,
there.
Real dominant.
Yeah.
Like, what's, you know, it was like, I was trying to talk, and
it was like quiet.
No, yeah, because, yeah. Oh, man.
How long do you feel you're on this journey?
About an hour.
2 hours and 35 minutes.
Oh, no, really, see, that's, no.
He had a lot to say.
Yeah.
How'd that selenite feel?
It feels really good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Good. It really connected you.
Yeah, it got me one part to where I was numb.
Couldn't even feel them, huh? Mm-hmm. Wonderful. So now that you've had this experience, how does it differ from you seeing the videos and having this?
You know that there's literally a connection, that you're doing this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that mm-hmm. it's real.
Yeah.
Yeah. I do remember asking about the Bell's palsy,
mm-hmm.
and because it's like acting up now.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember, yeah.
He basically said no.
Yeah.
Nope.
Yeah, I was hoping for something different with that.
Yeah, but you know, we gotta go with whatever.
Yeah.
Whatever they tell you. So, I know it was very long. The past life was basically floating through space and time, and who knows what that was. Do you want to share the any part of it?
Yeah.
Yeah? You want to share the Oversoul part?
Sure.
That
yeah.
seems to be okay. the meat of it.
We can share it all. I don't have, no.
Okay, cool. All right, so let me disconnect you. All right, so we just had a really
explosive time,
man. You're higher self, your Oversoul was spanking you.
Yeah.
Spanking you. So tell everybody how this went for you, what you expected, and what you got.
Wow. Okay.
Tell the truth.
Right. What I expected was,
thinking I'm going to be, oh, I see. I felt more. And that's pretty much what I know I'm needing to do more, you know. And
so you were told basically that you were spending too much time.
Seeing. Up there.
Up here. Like,
yeah.
Get your feet on the ground.
Yeah. And this experience, I wish I could have. I'm still trying to take it. I'm sorry, everyone.
It's gonna,
my words right now.
It's going to take a while. I mean, you're just on the spot. It's going to take you a few days to just get a grasp of it.
Yeah.
Really.
Yeah. I would say, my goodness.
Well,
you gotta come. It's it's different than what I thought. That's all I can say. I mean, you come with a preconceived notion of like what you think it is, but you're actually end up talking. I'm inside.
Yes, you know, it's all inside. All the answers are within. And people think that they're going to be getting, everybody thinks that this is going to be one way and it ends up something else. Now you came a long way for this. Where did you come from?
Yeah, I came from Ohio, like right outside of Youngstown. It's called Diamond, if anybody knows. Right.
And it was worth it?
It very much was. Very much was.
Mm-hmm.
She's amazing. She's amazing.
He did it.
Yeah, yeah.
He did all the work.
Yeah, well, I mean.
Your higher soul, your whole soul was like.
Really?
Yeah.
I loved it.
Yeah, it was good. So in the next 3 days, you're going to be wide open. You're going to be getting messages like crazy. I'm sure you're going to be floating out of here.
Yeah, I feel like I'm floating right now. I keep looking over there at those palm trees. I was like,
And one thing that your Oversoul said was.
Hey.
Relax.
Hey.
You gotta put that
I'm
on your chest.
Look, watch
there
this.
Put it right on you.
Wow.
Isn't that amazing?
Wow. Yeah.
That's what you have to do is more relaxing.
Yeah.
So would you recommend this experience to others?
I most definitely would.
And how would you prepare for something like this?
I would say stop preparing. I mean, that's the real advice that I can give would be literally try to empty yourself of whatever you think that you're going to encounter here. And then it's easier said than done, but.
Yeah, just go for it.
You just go for it.
Go for
yeah.
it.
And if you feel led to come, if you're feeling that truly, it's yourself. And
mm-hmm. It's nothing outside of yourself. It's not like you're getting information from anywhere else. Everything is within.
Yeah,
so if you would like a session with me, you can go to albaweinman.com, just schedule it, and we'll see each other soon. Okay? Okay, until the next time.
Bye.
Come on.
Wow.
Oh.
Great.
Excellent.